Hello friends, welcome to my channel Textile Gyan. I am Prakash Kude, assistant professor in MLU Textile Engineering College. We will see how you can calculate the weight of warp and weft yarn of the given fabric. So before that, we need to know how the fabric specification or construction has been written. They can be written in two different ways. One in which EPI and PPI has been mentioned at the top, while warp count and weft count of that fabric are mentioned at the bottom, while at the same time the fabric width has been given. So for example, here we can see that one construction parameter of one fabric has been given. So it has been written that ends per inch is 50, picks per inch has been 54, warp count is 30 and 40 is your weft count, and fabric width is 65 inch. Similarly, there is another way how we can mention this fabric specification. That could be your warp count has been at the top, weft count, and at the bottom, we have the ends per inch and picks per inch of that particular fabric. And fabric width also mentions. Here you can see the same construction parameter of both the fabric is there, but the way of writing the specification can be different. So now we'll see how you can calculate the weight of the warp and weft for the production of particular length of the fabric. So in this example, we can see here, we need to calculate the weight of warp and weight of weft in kg to produce the 4000 meter of the following fabric. The construction parameters are here. Here you can, from this, we can say that the ends per inch for this fabric is 60, picks per inch is 50, warp count required is your 40s, weft count is 30s, and the fabric width is 58 inch, and warp crimp and weft crimp is 8%. So for this particular fabric, how much amount of warp is required and how much amount of weft is required for the production of this fabric of length 4000 meter. Now we'll see it, the weight of warp yarns required for the production of the fabric. So in this case, we know that the EPI is 60, warp count is 40, fabric width is 58, warp crimp is 8%, and the length of fabric is 4000 meters. And in our yarn numbering systems, we know that the English count is your number of hanks of 840 yards, which weighs in 1 pound. So that can be written in mathematically as English count is equal to length in yards divided by 840 into weight in pound. So now we need to calculate the weight of yarns, which is in kg form. So how you can get to know the weight of warp in kg? That is equal to the length in yards we required, but the length of the fabric we have given is your in meter. So that's why I need to multiply it by 1.1, so that I can get the length in yards divided by 840 into yarn count and multiplied by 2.205. Why I am multiplied it by 2.205? Because I need to convert this weight from pounds to the kg. So now in this case, I need the total length of warp yarns. So before that, we need to know how much number of warp yarns are there in the fabric. So that can be found it by, if we know the ends per inch, we know that is 60 ends are there in 1 inch. If you multiply it by fabric width, we get to know the total number of ends or warp ends are there. So that we found it as 3480. So from that, another term we need to know, that is the length of each end. Length of each end in meter we required. So that can be taken from, as we know that the length of the fabric is 4000 meters. So at least 4000 meter length of the each end will be there. But in this, we need to multiply it by your crimp percentage. Why need to add this crimp percentage? Because the actual length of the fabric is your 4000 meter, but for the production of this 4000 meter of the yarn fabric, we need the yarn length should be more than that of the, because of the crimp. So in this case, how you can get to know the length of each end in meter, like the length of the fabric is 4000. If you add this 8% to this, you'll get to know the total length of the yarns which required for the each end is 4320. So at least we can see that around 320 meters of the extra length is going into your cream. So from that, we can get to know the total length of warp yarns. Now we need to know the total length of warp yarns. So how we can get to know? As we have find the total number of ends. So total number of ends are 3480. If you multiply it by this total number of ends into the length of each end, so that will give us the total length of warp yarns is required for the production of this 4000 meter of the fabric. So total length of the warp yarn is required is given as 3480, which is the total number of ends. If you multiply it by 4320, that is the length of each end, we get to know the total length of the warp yarns. So similarly, we need to find the weight of warp which is required to produce this fabric. So now we have find this total length of warp yarn, that is equal to this. If you multiply it by 1.1, so the length has been converted into yards, and the warp count we know, that is your 40s. So from this we got the total weight of the warp which is required for the production of the fabrics, that is in the 223 kg. Now for calculation of your weft yarn weight, as we know that these are the construction parameters are there, where PPI is 50, weft count is 30, fabric width is 58, weft crimp is 8%, and the length of the fabric is 4000. Similar to your weight of warp calculations, we are using this English count formula, where we need to find the weight of weft yarn in kg, where we need to know the total length of weft yarn in yards. So here, as the here weft yarn length is also in meter, that's why we need to multiply it by 1.1, and if you divide it by 840 and weft yarn count, and into multiplied by 2.205. So now you need to know the total length of weft yarns. So in this case, the total length of weft is can be found. Before that, we need to know the total number of picks are there. So how we can get to know the total number of picks? That will be equal to picks per inch. How much number of picks has been inserted in 1 inch? If you multiply it by the total length of the fabric, we get to know the total number of picks. Why I multiplied by 39.37? Because I need to convert this meter into inch form. So that's why I have multiplied it by 39.37. So that will give the total number of picks which has been inserted for production of this fabric. Now we need to find the total length of the weft yarns in meter. So that will be equal to the total number of picks into fabric width into web cream percentage we need to add. Similar to your warp, if you are finding the your warp length, in that we are adding the warp cream. Similar to this, we need to add your web cream also. So the total number of picks inserted are 78,74,000. So in this case, and the fabric width is 58 inch, so all the units need to be in meter form. That's why I need to convert it into meter. So 58 inch divided by 39.37, that will give the fabric width in inch. If we multiply it by the fabric crimp percentage, we'll get to know the total length of weft yarns is required for the production of this fabric. So total length of the fabric we get from this. So from this, how you can get to know the weight of weft in kg? That will be equal to the total length of the weft yarns. So that will be here. If you multiply it by 1.1, that will be converted into yards, divided by 840 into weft yarn count. Weft yarn count is your 30, and if you multiply it by 2.205 to cover conversion of your pounds to the kg, so total weight of the weft is required is 248 kg. Similarly, the weight of warp and weft can be found in terms of the pound by the following formula. As weight of warp yarn in pounds, that will be equal to the ends per inch into fabric width. So that will give the total number of ends if you multiply it by the fabric length, and if you multiply it again with the crimp percentage, that will ultimately give the total length of warp yarns required for this fabric productions divided by 840 into warp counts. So from that we get to know the how much amount of warp is required for the production of that particular length of the fabric. Similarly, the weight of warp yarns can be given as PPI into fabric length in yards, that will ultimately give the total number of picks which has been inserted in the fabric. If we multiply it by the fabric width, get and along with the web crimp percentage, we get to know the total length of the webbed yarns required for the fabric productions divided by 840 into web counts. So that will ultimately gauge the total weight of your web. So total weight of the fabric can be given as the weight of warp plus weight of webbed yarns. I will take one problem where we need to calculate the weight of warp and weight of webbed in terms of the pound to produce the 2500 yards of the fabric, where whose parameters are been given as construction parameters are 80 ends per inch, 70 picks per inch, 30 warp count, 40 webbed count, and 62 inch your fabric width. And warp crimp and web crimp has been given as 8% and 10% respectively. And as we know that weight of warp in the pounds can be calculated by the ends per inch, that is your 80. If you multiply it by width of the fabric, that is 62. And again, we need to multiply it by the total length of the fabric, that is 2500 yards. And in that, we need to multiply it by the warp crimp percentage. So that will be your 100 plus 8 upon 100 and divided by 840 into warp count. So that is 30 is your warp count. So from that, we get to know the total weight of warp required for the production of 2500 yards of the fabric. So that will be equal to your 531 pound. Similarly, the weight of webbed yarns can be calculated as the picks per inch, that is 70. If we multiply it by the length of the fabric, we'll get to know the total number of picks. And again, if you multiply it by the width of the fabric along with the web crimp percentage, we'll get to know the total length of the webbed. Length of the webbed in yards and divided by 840 into webbed count. Web count here is 40. So we'll get to know the total weight of webbed. So that is your 355 pound. So from that, we get to know the total weight of the fabric for production of, if you are producing your 2500 yards of the fabric. So that will comes around 886 pounds. So thank you so much, students, for your kind attentions. Stay tuned to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also like, share and comment on this video.